Everyone, and welcome to the next lesson, which will be on the Django admin panel. Okay, so we're kind of going to do two things at once here, but let's focus at the first thing, exploring the Django admin panel. So first of all, let's turn on our server. Okay, so we just want to run it, make sure it's running. And let's refresh, it's okay. Okay, so let's head over to our admin page. So you'll just add the route admin. Okay, as you'll see here, this is our Django admin page, and we need a username and a password to be able to log in here. Okay, so basically on the Django admin page, you can do lots of tasks here. So basic admin tasks on your website and so on. You can, of course, view your models, you'll register your models and you'll view them. You can delete objects and so on. So let's head on back here to our project, and we want to close our server for now. So we need to write a following command to create a super user. So we can say python manage.py create super user. Okay, then we need to put in a name. So I'm just going to say honor. So my name here as a username, email, we can leave this blank. It's okay. And then the password. So you won't be able to see the password, but make sure that you remember what you put in, what you type here. Okay. And there we go. So it says super user created successfully. And we can log in with this user by this username that we created and the password that we entered. So we need to now turn on our server so that we get access to our admin page. So let's run this. Perfect. All right, this is good. So now we can put in the username and password that we created. And here we are. So of course, this is the Django administration page or the Django admin panel. And of course, like I said, this is where we can do some site administration. So we can already see we have our two models here, which is users. And we have our super user here. And of course, you can see here, if you click on it, you can delete the user, but don't do that, please. But theoretically, you would click the checkbox, click here, and then you would say go. And then it would come with a prompt saying, are you sure you want to delete this user? And so on. So this is just some of the tasks you can do. You can also delete here. We also have groups here. So we have some models already done for us. So under authentication and authorization. So this is the Django admin panel. Okay. So we can log out here for now and head over to our homepage. Okay. So that is the Django admin panel. So what I want us to do now is I want us now to register our model. So remember, we created a model here called task, and now I want us to register this model. So what we'll do to do that is go to admin.py. So admin.py, of course, is interlinked with our Django admin panel. Okay, so let's add some space. And as you can see here, there's a default comment here that says register your models here. Okay, so of course, the Django admin panel here, okay, it imports admin for us, so that is great. But we need to, first of all, before we can register our model, we need to call it from our models.py file. And to do that, we need to say from .models import and then our class name. So our class name here was task. So we can say task. There we go. So now we can make use of this model here and register it. Now the registration is super easy. You can just say admin.site.register, and then in parentheses, you can say task, which of course comes from here, and we register our task. So when we go back to our admin page and we log in, so let's log in. Let's log in here. And we can see here under our app here to do, we have a model here, which is called task. Now, I know it has an S here, but don't worry, Django automatically appends an S for some reason. So you don't need to worry about that for your model. So I know we called it task, but Django always adds an S. So don't worry about that. So if we click in there and we go to add a task, you can see here we have our attributes title and content, which of course is from here, our two attributes. You'll notice date posted isn't there, but the reason for this is because this is handled automatically and we shouldn't, and we're not supposed to alter this. So this is added on its own in between the scene, in, well, behind the scenes, on its own. Okay, but we do have our two attributes here, title and content, which we can actually, we can, for example, add a task here. So I'm going to add a task here to say clean the house. And I'm going to say done by 6 p.m. And I can say save. So this is me adding an object. So I've added an object here. So this is the good thing about the Django admin panel. So you can also create objects here manually. And of course, you can click on them here, say delete the selected tasks, and go. Then it will come with a prompt here telling us, are we sure we want to do this? And then we'll, and then it will say that this is from the model task and the object task object one. And we can say, yes, I'm sure. And there we go. So this is the good thing about the Django admin panel. So you can also see the recent actions, what you've been doing. Eventually you can view the site, change the password, log out. So this is a very nice thing that the Django developers have built in for us. Okay, so this is pretty much everything I wanted to show you on the Django admin panel, and of course how to register a user, register our model task. Okay, so of course one more thing I want to show you here in the blue, these are our apps. So this is authentication or summarization. This is that app. So if we go to settings.py, of course our admin and auth apps. Our admin and auth apps, of course, are referenced here, and our to-do app, which we referenced here, and under this, under these apps are our models. Okay, so I just wanted to make that clear. Okay, so of course, our task model is here under our to-do app, which is here. Okay, so I just wanted to quickly explain the structure there. Okay, so that's it.